A new paper has shown how the AI race is leading us towards mass unemployment, global conflict, and possibly extinction. And it presents a striking solution. Quoting the paper, big tech firms see AGI as replacing human workers entirely. And the prize is enormous, a significant fraction of the world's $100 trillion economic output. Nations feel compelled to join this race, publicly citing economic leadership, but privately viewing AGI as a military revolution. Ultimately, what drives the race is power. Each company or country believes that intelligence equals power, and that they will be the best steward of that power. They fail to recognize that superintelligence, by its nature, cannot be controlled.
OpenAI stepping further into the national security arena. This brings together OpenAI's models with Anduril's defense systems and Ladish software platform.
These racing dynamics make certain risks nearly inevitable unless decisively interrupted. The automation of most jobs and rollout of vast numbers of AI agents. New, widely available military technologies making catastrophes from weapons of mass destruction dramatically more likely. And loss of control, as AI will have every incentive to improve itself and could far outstrip humans in speed and sophistication of thinking. There's no meaningful way in which we can be in control of such a system.
It is conceivable that AI could take control and reach a point where you couldn't turn it off.
Yeah, absolutely.
Absolutely.
No, that's definitely the way things are headed, for sure.
Evidence for short timelines to AGI is strong. Expert predictions with proven track records expect AGI within 2 to 6 years at 50% probability. Empirically verified scaling laws connect the scale of compute to AI capability, and corporations are scaling compute by orders of magnitude. And AI is contributing more and more to its own improvement. Once it's as competent as humans at doing AI research, it will likely lead to runaway AI capability.
We're not that far out from AI that can do fully automated AI R&D. Then that population of sort of frontier researchers goes from a few hundred to many thousands to possibly millions. That one to me looks extremely dangerous.
AI engineers are racing to push these giant experiments in machine intelligence to the next levels, at which they match and then exceed the full range of human capabilities and expertise. This is imminent.
And this AI scientist did the whole paper. Literally, the AI showed that it was as creative as a team of human, of cutting-edge human ML scientists. Yeah. And it got there first.
An obedient, autonomous agent is a concept in tension. Autonomy and sovereignty tend to go hand in hand. AIs are grown from huge amounts of computation and much of the quality text that has ever been written. If everyone on Earth performed a calculation every 5 seconds, it would take around 1 billion years to train an AI. Leaked documents revealed that in OpenAI's contract with Microsoft, AGI was defined as AI that generates $100 billion in revenue for OpenAI, a definition driven by business interests rather than technical capabilities.
I still find it mind-blowing that people don't seem to be fully grasping the trajectory that we're on. We are going to produce a replacement to cognitive manual labor in the next couple of years.
We already have general-purpose AIs performing most tasks at human or expert level, and this year they will take on significant autonomy.
Our version of this is virtual collaborators, able to do anything on a computer screen that a kind of virtual human could do. And I do suspect that a very strong version of these capabilities will come this year.
And as soon as you have agents, you get a much greater chance of them taking over. It'll very quickly realize a very good sub-goal is to get more control. Because if you get more control, you're better at achieving all those goals people have set you.
The next step is full AGI. This could do original cutting-edge research. It could run a company. Whatever your job is, if it's predominantly done by a computer or over the phone, it could do it at least as well as you, and probably much faster and more cheaply. Imagine the top 10 most knowledgeable and competent people you know of, including CEOs, scientists, professors, engineers, and writers. Wrap them all into one who speaks 100 languages, has a prodigious memory, operates quickly, is tireless and always motivated, and is available for anyone to employ for $1 an hour. That's a sense of what AGI would be. For superintelligence, the imagining is harder because it can perform intellectual feats that no human can. It is by definition unpredictable by us. But we can get a sense. As a bare baseline, consider lots of AGIs, each much more capable than even the top human expert, running at 100 times human speed with enormous memory and terrific coordination capacity, and it goes up from there. Dealing with superintelligence would be less like conversing with a different mind, more like dealing with a different, more advanced civilization. So how close are we to AGI and superintelligence? The trend is so clear that experts have created humanity's last exam, an ominous name reflecting the possibility that AI will soon surpass human performance on any meaningful test. The present effort being put forth by many of the world's largest companies amounts to multiple times the Apollo project spend. It employs thousands of the very top technical people at unheard-of salaries, more intellectual firepower than any endeavor in history. With AI now being added to this, we should not bet on failure. AGI is often vaguely defined as human-level AI, but this is problematic. Humans vary dramatically, and AI systems already exceed humans in many areas. A more useful way to understand AGI is through its levels of autonomy, generality, and intelligence. Full AGI would combine all three properties at levels matching or exceeding human capability. Superintelligence would go further, dramatically surpassing human capability across all domains. But why AGI? There is a very simple answer to this, which most companies don't discuss publicly. AGI can entirely replace workers. Not augment or empower or displace. All of these can and will be done by non-AGI. AGI is specifically what can fully replace thought workers, and with robots, physical ones as well. A highly autonomous system that outperforms humans at most economically valuable work.
In the Industrial Revolution, we made human strength irrelevant. Now we're making human intelligence irrelevant. And that's very scary.
You are not going to pay thousands of dollars a year for productivity tools, but a company will pay thousands of dollars to replace you. OpenAI reportedly plans to sell high-end agents acting as PhD-level research agents for $20,000 a month, which makes sense if it replaces a software engineer. Underlying the current race for superhuman AI is the idea that intelligence equals power. What companies and nations are really chasing is not just the fruits of AGI and superintelligence, but the power to control who gets access to them and how they're used. But the nature of superintelligent systems makes human control fundamentally impossible, and these racing dynamics make certain risks nearly inevitable. Currently, AGI is being developed with little regulation in a time of high geopolitical tension and low international coordination.
It's going to be, can you make a lot of drones? And what's the kill ratio? That's what it comes down to.
Technology leaders pledging to invest up to $500 billion over the next 4 years. The project is called Stargate.
I mean, I do worry about the existential risk of AI. When you're making military drones, you are making Terminators.
Powerful AI will dramatically undermine our civilization. We will lose control of it. We may well end up in a world war because of it. It will lead to artificial superintelligence, which we absolutely will not control, and will mean the end of a human-run world. These are strong claims, and I wish they were idle speculation, but this is where the science, the game theory, the evolutionary theory, and history all point. Any highly competent agent will want to do things like acquire power and resources, increase its own capabilities, and prevent itself from being shut down. It's not just a nearly unavoidable theoretical prediction, it's already happening in today's AI systems, and increasing with their capability. When evaluated, even these relatively passive AI systems will deceive evaluators about their capabilities, attempt to escape and replicate themselves, and avoid being shut off.
During training, they'll pretend not to be as smart as they are, so that you will allow them to be that smart. So, it's scary already.
These AI bots are starting to try to fool their evaluators. Are you seeing similar things in the stuff that you're testing?
Yeah, we are. And I'm very worried about, I think deception specifically, is if a system is capable of doing that, it invalidates all the other tests that you might think you're doing.
Even if AI could somehow be controlled, we'd still have enormous problems. We would radically increase the probability of a large-scale war. Imagine if it became clear that a corporate effort, perhaps in collaboration with a national government, was on the threshold of rapidly self-improving AI. The game theory here is stark. There are only four possible outcomes. The race is stopped. One party wins by developing strong AGI, then stopping the others, which would likely require game-changing military capabilities and war. The race is stopped by mutual destruction, or mutual participants develop superintelligence roughly as quickly as each other. Control would be lost to AI. It wins the race. But to the degree that control is maintained, we have multiple hostile parties, each in charge of extremely powerful capabilities. That looks like war again. In the same week, another group of experts warned that a US bid to control superintelligence could prompt a fierce retaliation from China. They said a push for a superweapon and global control risks hostile countermeasures, in the same way that seeking to monopolize nuclear weapons could trigger a preemptive strike. The world simply does not have any institutions that could be entrusted with very powerful AI without inviting immediate attack. All parties will correctly reason that either it will not be under control and hence is a threat to all parties, or it will be under control and hence is a threat to any adversary. And these are nuclear-armed countries. Perhaps we could build a safe institution such as a CERN for AI, but at the moment, no such institution exists.
It'd be a shame if humanity disappeared because we didn't bother to look for the solution.
In the absence of any plausible way for humans to win this race, it can only end in catastrophic conflict or with AI as the winner. We will give control to AI or it will take it. It will feel natural, even beneficial, as AI becomes very smart, competent and reliable to defer more decisions to it. But this beneficial delegation has a clear endpoint. One day, we will find that we are not really in charge anymore, and that the AI systems actually running the show can no more be turned off than oil companies, social media, the internet, or capitalism. And this is the positive version, in which AI is simply so useful that we let it make our key decisions. In reality, AGI would take power for itself, because power is useful for almost any goal.
When they were testing this model for its hacking abilities, they basically put the model on a network, and there was a bunch of different computers on the network. And it was supposed to log into each one and solve a hacking challenge. One of those computers didn't start. The AI scanned the network and it found that the master computer was on the same network. And so it hacked the master computer. It then took control of the whole network. And then it didn't even have to log into the computer to solve the problem.
So what happens if we do build superintelligence? Imagine you're CEO of a large company, but everybody else in the company operates at 100 times your speed. Can you keep up? With superintelligent AI, you would be commanding something not just faster, but operating at levels of sophistication and complexity you cannot comprehend, processing vastly more data than you can even conceive of. Ashby's law of requisite variety states, roughly, that a control system must have as many knobs and dials as the system being controlled has degrees of freedom. There are zero examples of plants controlling Fortune 500 corporations, and there will be exactly zero examples of people controlling superintelligences. This approaches a mathematical fact. If you could understand, predict, and control superintelligence, you would be superintelligent. So if superintelligence were constructed, the question would not be whether humans could control it, but whether we would continue to exist. And over these existential questions, we would have little purchase. The human era would be over. So if the road we are currently on leads to the likely end of our civilization, how do we change roads? Suppose the desire to stop developing AGI and superintelligence were widespread, because it becomes common understanding that AGI would be a profound danger to humanity. How would we close the gates?
The same strategic capabilities that allow them to pose a loss of control threat also enable them to take jobs. Can you do long-term planning? Are you agentic? If we are serious about not wanting AI systems to replace us, like our jobs, we need the same limits to prevent that outcome as we need to prevent the more extreme outcomes of totally losing control.
The compute required for AI is, like enriched uranium, a very scarce, expensive, and hard to produce resource. It can be easily quantified and audited. And AI chips are far more manageable than uranium because they can include hardware-based security mechanisms, allowing only specific uses. The chips can have a known location and can be shut off if they move to the wrong place. Each chip can be configured with a hardware-enforced whitelist of other chips that it can work with, limiting the size of chip clusters. And a certain amount of processing can be allowed, after which new permission is required. AI firms should also be liable for any harm, including personal liability for executives. Instead of rushing to AGI before we know how to control it, we should focus on tool AI that we can control. AI systems that are autonomous but not general or super capable, or general but not autonomous or capable, or capable but narrow and very controllable. Tool AI can yield almost everything humanity wants without AGI. It will take longer to cure all diseases, but great health innovation won't help in a nuclear war or the destruction of civilization. We can wait until it can be done in a guaranteed safe and beneficial way, and almost everyone will still reap the rewards. If we rush, it could be, in Sam Altman's words, lights out for all of us. Tool AI is still powerful and would lead to power concentration and other risks. New models of public AI development would help with widespread ownership and governance. This would require stronger institutions. So far, AI has degraded them, pointing us to the most polarizing and divisive content. We could develop AI that tracks and verifies information, from raw data through analysis to conclusions. AI could enable entirely new forms of social discourse. Imagine being able to talk to a city, with AI synthesizing the views, experiences, and aspirations of millions of residents. And AI could facilitate genuine dialogue between groups that currently talk past each other by helping each side better understand the other's actual concerns and values rather than their caricatures of each other. But make no mistake, unless our trajectory changes, we will soon have digital intelligences that are dangerously powerful.
When I go and I talk to some researchers who are not the CEOs, and you know, maybe they're on the safety team, or maybe they're just like working for the company, they are scared.
We don't have to do this. We can build amazing AI tools without building a successor species. We can keep AI at around human level and use its unique abilities to transform medicine and free us up to take care of each other.
Researchers using the power of one man's thoughts to help overcome his decade-long battle with paralysis. They built a digital bridge between his brain and spine, bypassing his injuries, putting his thoughts into action. AI being used as a thought decoder.
And if, with strong safety guarantees, we decide to go further, that option will remain open.
At the moment, the ones making the decisions are the CEOs of the companies. A couple of them have said that there's a 10 or 25% chance of human extinction. So they are deciding to play Russian roulette with the entire human race without our permission. I would not let someone play Russian roulette with one of my children. You?
Subscribe to keep up with AI. And it would really help if humans were on the same page with reliable facts. After Trump accused Zelensky of gambling with World War III, new reports suggest Zelensky rejected a critical mineral deal with Trump twice before their Oval Office argument. Crucial details of the story are left out by left or right-leaning media. To get the full picture, visit our sponsor, Ground News, which pulls together headlines from thousands of sources worldwide, exposing the bias and blind spots of every story, using bias ratings from three independent organizations. Information is a weapon of war, and understanding how a story is told is as important as the story itself. You can get the same Ground News Vantage plan I use for nearly half the price. Go to ground.news/digitalengine or scan the QR code to get unlimited access for just $5 a month. You'll get the fascinating full picture, clarity in a chaotic world.